way through. So now there's a pin, and then this chain's going to come apart. And right here are your little X-ring oil ring thingamajigs that hold the oil in. So don't lose those. And so now the whole chain will come off. All right. We can clean it or oil it or whatever. It's a good idea to have another spare master. So this one's the same way. What you do is you put it in, and then we'll squeeze that and give it a little flare so it doesn't pop off. Really, there's only this rod and this shock holding it on. So to get to these, there's a funky angle, and we have to take this chain guard off in order to get to the bottom, in order to get to this bolt. So we're gonna do that one, that one. That one's covered by that one, so we gotta get that one. Not too dirty. That's good. This thing will just come off. And this is designed to let the chain ride on it, so you, when the chain slaps, it doesn't damage the swing arm. No metal on metal. And then this little tab pulls out, just sits in there, and then this is the axle that holds it in. Take this little brake mount off, and then I'm gonna take the shock off. The shock will drop down, and then the swing arm, we can lift it up and change the angle on these so they're a little bit easier to get to. So this is an 8. Got a ratchet. Use a ratchet. Where's my ratchet? Now we can pull this bolt out. A little up. So, where did our 8mm go? Did you touch it? Here it is. So now we should be able to lift this up. Bolts. technically that thing shouldn't have to come all the way out. We just gotta loosen the pinch bolt. You're so close, dude. Technically, that thing should come out. I'm gonna hold it back up a little bit. That nut. And then we just have to drive that. So let's try a BFH. See what happens. Oh shit. Look at that shit. Just goes right out. Excellent. Okay, so not so easy. There may be some shims in here. So that's your swing arm axle. This is where it's riding inside the motor, right? We can pull pin. Gotta watch the brake. Here's a shim. Keep that. Out. So here's the steel axle. It's in good shape, honest. There's no reason to change it for me. Let's check. Wait. Weight-wise, I'm going to say pretty close. This one may be a little bit lighter, the aluminum one, but it looks better. So this one we'll have to strip and get powder coated. So I don't see any cracks. So definitely reusable. Aluminum is definitely lighter. I don't want to have to go get a scale and prove it, so you'll just have to take my word for it. And then here's where we're working. So the swing arm is rotating on that edge. And then there's a little roller bearing in there. We're gonna have to re-shim it. So it's gonna take a minute. This is almost like a race. Let me see. Yeah. Oh, here it is. You guys, why don't you tell me when it falls out? And then this aluminum one came with a whole bunch of them. Just in case, I guess. So first we're just gonna get it up in there and see what kind of play we got going back and forth. This axle has a circlip on one side and not on the other. So
it can only go in one way.
Move this over. Quite a bit of play. Ducati wants most of the gap on the right side.
Oh shit.
That's touching the sprocket. Get it out there. Now is it touching the sprocket? No. Okay. Man, that's a tight clearance. So now we're just gonna fit some shims. See what happens. We'll go right back with what there was before. See how that does. So we're gonna thread our doodad through, right? And get the shims on there a little bit. Pull it back. That's not gonna work. Okay, we're right there. So now we want to check for wiggle. I gotta put another shim in. 0.1 millimeter of play. 0.1 millimeter. Okay, put another shim in it. And then push this out. Okay. This one's cleaned up pretty good. We should be able to go. Right in between here. Technically speaking. I have a lip on there, right? No. Nope. Okay. Try not to fall. I'll hold you. And then I do this. Yeah. I'm gonna sit down. Don't hit my head. Okay. Pretty close. I think I can move it. Yeah. Okay. This time when we put the axle in, rotating pin, whatever you want to call it, we're going to give it a light coat of grease for where it sits on those bearings. Check for a wobble. Nada. We're good. Did you get that? Yeah, you got that. Okay, I gotta change battery. Hold on. So I switched you back to the stool so I can sit. So we got our shims right. I'm shocked. Okay. So now we don't have any side-to-side play, right? Now, you gotta cinch these down. And I'm gonna start over there. Oh shit, I guess that's tight enough. I don't want to drop the bike off the stupid jack. Check for play. No play. I like it. I like it a lot. So now, you can drop that down and install our accessory pieces, so to speak. So let me see if I can get this brake rotor or brake caliper assembly in here. Come in this way. Yeah. Perfect. chain guard. Now I put the shock on and hold it all together. So for this one, it has a slightly longer bolt and a nut because the cylinder was not threaded. So we put in our doodad bushing. Punch. Shit, 17. Glove on. Like that. Okay. Now, put our chain guard on. We can do a chain. First, let's wipe it off. Here's the difference, right? So this one's like steel colored, and then the rest of them, these are, they're kind of yellowish. So I like to put it on the same way I took it off. You know what I mean? It's reversible, but that. But let me get my tool and glove. Okay, there we go. So there's our chain. Pressed on. Tight, but it's not kinked. Can you tell it's been a long time since I used this? This is the handle that screws into the bottom, so you can hold everything. I think the last time I used it was on the Honda. That's been a while. Chain's on. Now, a chain guard. This thing's bigger. That's what it is. So this is going to have to get trimmed. We will do that tomorrow after we get the tire on. Then we'll know how high the chain's going to sit. Do I really need to do that tomorrow? You know what? I don't even want it. We'll just put the screw in. I gotta go inside. My back's killing me, dude. So now we're ready for tire and rim. We got the aluminum swing arm on. We got everything set. It's installed. We got our chain put back together. So we're ready to go. Should be picking up tires and wheels in the morning. And then we have to put the exhaust on, and then we have to put the body paint. There's so much to do, so much more to do. But thanks for watching. So that's all for today's episode on the Ducati modifications. Thanks for watching. If you like anything you see, hit the like button. It's over here. And if you want to keep getting notifications and getting told that there's a new video, hit the subscribe button. It's over here. I appreciate it. Thanks. Y'all take care. Oh, let me check my hair. Yeah, not too bad.